गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम दर्शना मोरे, प्रोफेसर ऑफ केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ हॉर्टिकल्चर नासिक। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी ऑलरेडी सीन अबाउट द ऑयल पाम कल्टिवेशन, टैक्सोनॉमिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, देन ओरिजिन, प्लांटिंग, प्रोपाइगेशन, डिफरेंट वराइटीज ऑफ ऑयल पाम। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी अबाउट द इरीगेशन, कवर क्रॉपिंग, irrigation at the rate of 100 liters of water per palm per day and 100 to 150 liters of water per palm per day and even up to the 200 liters of water per palm day in hot summer has to be provided during the dry period to realize the yield potential of the palm. Yield may increases if the irrigation is increases. It is attributed as increase the leaf production, increase in the number of bunches, better sex ratio, and the reduction in abortion of female flowers. After 28 months of irrigation, increases was from 1 tons per hectare to 4.50 tons per hectare. Drip irrigation mostly followed for the irrigation. 4 drippers discharging of 150 to 200 liters of water in 5 to 6 hours. Then cover cropping. For the cover cropping, there are different species, plant species are used for the cover cropping. First one, Puraria fasciolens, then Calopogonium, Myconoids, Centrosema pubescens, and Mycona bractata. A cover crop introduced in Kerala from Tripura. It is not flowering under the Kerala Agriculture University condition. Hence propagated through stem cutting. So that's why the seed rate of these species are 2 to 3 kg per hectare. Establishment of cover crops is in a hot water treatment 50 to 60 degrees Celsius for the cover crop seeds. Soaking of seeds for 2 hours improves the establishment, resulting in the good cover. Then second one, seed treatment is rhizobium culture at the rate 1 gram per kg of seed. Then leaf pruning in oil palm. Development of leaves in the crown of palm is initially slow. Each leaf remains enclosed for about 2 years and then develop into the central sphere. That is a spindle leaf before the opening. Then leaf stalk is strong and fibrous and is almost 8 meter long. The mature leaf may have 250 to 300 leaflets, each about 1.3 meter long and 6 centimeter broad. This is leaf characteristics of oil palm. The rate of leaf production in oil palm, 20 to 25 leaves per year. Each leaf will also carry one inflorescence. Then present persistence of leaves in oil palm. The leaf base adhere to the stem for about 12 years and longer and fall away gradually. Then frond pruning in oil palm has influence on yield and hence is of economic importance. If pruning of frond has not been attained, it results in interferes with the pollination, both assisted and natural, artificial and natural. Then visual assessment of fruit ripens. Excessive pruning is harmful, causes the reduction in yield. So that's why leaf pruning is very important in oil palm. Then immature, that is pre-bearing period. Removal of senescent and useless fronds which are laying very close to the soil surface. Annual leaf production in area about 6, while in coconut 12 to 14 leaves, oil palm 12 leaves. Adult palm, adult 30 to 35 top leaves are left undisturbed on adult palms. Each palm produces about 24 leaves annually, that is 2 leaves per month. Then ablation in palm. Ablation, that means it refers to removal of young male and female inflorescence and bunches during the first 3 years of palm growth. Ablation That means removal of male and female flowers in the initial first 3 years. Other terms used for the ablation operation are disbudding and deflowering. Frequency of ablation. Ablation should be done at monthly intervals by cutting with the help of narrow bladed chisel. Then purpose of ablation is uneconomic processing by collection of few bunches in the initial years of bearing. Then leftover bunches may rot or dead to outbreak of diseases and pest. Then diversion of nutrients from palm growth from base from these bunches and inflorescence and result into the uniform palm stand. Then period of ablation 14 to 26 months after planting. Ablation can be commenced after about 4 months of field planting and continue till 26 months when about 70% of palms have produced inflorescence at an interval of 4 to 5 months. Then some of the this pest in oil palm. First one is the rodent rat damage. Control management, tapping at different bites such as iron leaf trap, snap trap, death fall trap, blow trap, then cage trap, spin death trap, bamboo nose trap may be used to minimize the rat damage. Orchard sanitation, poisoning bite, acute rate of poisoning, rodenticides such as the zinc phosphide, single dose anticoagulants like bromadiolone 0.005%, multiple dose anticoagulants, rodenticides, warfarin, fumarin are placed in the field in the evening and removed in the morning. Dead rats should be buried to avoid the secondary poisoning. Then mechanical barriers, oil palm seedling at the time planting can be covered with 22 gauge galvanized iron wire mesh around bowl as a prophylactic measures against rats and porcupines, etc. Next one is the biological control. Predators for rats include snakes, vultures, mangroves, then cats and dogs. Then diseases in oil palm. Spread rot, bird rot, bunch failure are the major diseases in oil palm and basal stem rot. That is Ganoderma disease. Spread rot, it is a lethal and infection disease found in the oil palm plantation of Kerala. Causes of this disease is several microorganisms are associated with this disease and most common ones are fungi, Fusarium monilifermi and the Colitotrichum chloride spores, MLO and black bacteria. Symptoms, yellowing of youngest wall of the unfolded leaves, yellowing of youngest wall of unfolded leaves is the initial symptoms. Yellowing start from the tips of leaves and spread mostly along the margin of leaves. Then chlorotic area later turns brown to dries up. Management, in a view of uncertain etiology, rogging. Rugging of the affected palm is recommended to prevent the spread of this malady. Where have to be go for rugging? Root wilt disease in coconut and yellow leaf disease in affected coconut and areca nut palms also from the vicinity. Then barriers trees, raising quick growing barriers trees in the border of the plantation to prevent the vector movement from root wilt disease and yellow leaf disease sources. Then disorder in oil palm, bunch failure. Bunch failure in the development of bunches at any stage during the anthesis to harvest is referred as bunch failure. Periodically, palm cleaning reduces the bed of inoculum and fresh incidence. Not specifically known. Excessive pruning, mutual shedding, then under pollination or release of pollinating weevil, noxious stress, prolonged rot, inadequate nutrient status, and overbearing increases the bunch failure. Control measures, There is no recovery once branch failure has started, and hence all control measures must be added and avoid those conditions favoring branch failure. Then harvesting, processing and yield of oil palm. Pre-bearing age oil palm is 3 years. Economic life of oil palm is 25 years. If the cluster are too high of to cut with the long arm sickle, use bamboo bladders and it's climb up to up the tree with belt. Then you can also wear the spike shoes. First harvest in oil palm start three to four years after planting. Then fruit maturity period, from the period of flowering it takes about 180 days, 6 months from pollination to maturity. Then stages of harvesting. Fully ripe bunches are harvested. Immature bunches and partially rotten bunches are not suited because it results in a low oil recovery of poor quality. Change in color. When the colors of fruit change from black to orange and red to yellowish orange. Detachment of fruits. For the practical purpose, when the few fruits, say around 100 fruits or more, detached or easily removable for the young palm and 5 fruits for the adult palm, are detached from the bunch. Then change in fruit texture. Fruit becomes fruit when the ripe and fruits can be pressed with the fingers with ease. Then overripe fruits reduces the quality, quantity and the quality of oil. If harvesting is delayed, the fats is converted into the free fatty acids and glycerols. Harvesting is done at a ripe stage. In harvesting interval, as the oil synthesis and the free fatty acids formation occur during the ripening process, harvesting should be carried out as frequently as possible in order to reduce the number of overripe bunches. Harvesting should be done at every 7 to 14 days interval. Then harvesting tools. When the palms are young, chisel attached to the tip of 1.2 to 1.5 meter long stick of wood and of light hollow metal pipe with handle. When palms grow older, use wider chisel about 14 centimeter wide and the long stick. Harvested fresh fruit bunches have to be transported to the factory as quickly as possible and at any cost, not later than 1 day, within a 24 hours. Yield. The average weight of harvested fruit bunches will be 30 kg. Average number of bunches per 10 to 12, and the bunch weight is 30 to 40 kg per bunch. Average fresh fruit bunches yield per year per hectare 12 tons. Oil recovery from FFB 18 to 21%, that is extraction of ration from the oil to bunch 20%. Under good management, fresh fruit branches 20 to 30 tons per hectare, yielding 4 to 5 tons of oil. However, an average 12 tons of fresh fruit bunches can be obtained per hectare per year, yielding 2.5 tons of oil from the oil palm. Then processing of oil palm. The fruit of oil palm should be processed with a few hours after the harvesting to obtain the good quality oil. This will be deterioration of oil due to the over-ripening, storage damage, fruits, and this method of processing. Dry process involves sterilization, stripping, fruit digestion, then pressing, clarification, etc. Edible palm oil should contain less than 2% of free fatty acids. Then composition of oil palm. First one, part of the fruit use mesocarp. Then oil extraction from the mesocarp. Then kernel and endosperm. Oil percentage in the fruit part use from the mesocarp, 45 to 50% of oil obtained, and from the kernel or endosperm, 50% oil obtained. Color of mesocarp, light yellow to orange red depending on the amount of carotenoids present, and the kernel color resembles coconut oil, like nearly colorless. Then processing for the palm oil extraction. As oil is extracted from the mesocarp portion of the fruit, the method of oil extraction is entirely different, and wet processing was of the major problem in oil extraction. In oil is deterioration of oil into the free fatty acids, which results in poor quality oil. Then factor affecting quality of oil by increasing free fatty acids content should be less than 2% for using its edible oil. Time gap between harvesting and processing fresh fruit bunches at the rate 24 hours. Fruit bunches of oil palm should be processed within 24 hours after the harvest to get the good quality of oil. During processing, oil palm fresh fruit bunches are sterilized in steam boiling water 30 minutes to 60 minutes to inactivate the fat splitting enzymes. Then bruising, crushed brown, bad handling, delayed processing, overripe fruit bunches. Fruit bunches are to be processed within 24 hours of harvesting if at all it has to be stored, and it has to be sterilized and stored. Sterilization of FFB. After harvesting, bunches are sterilized at 130 degrees Celsius for 1 hour under the pressure of 2 kg per centimeter square. Stages of processing. Palm oil processing unit operation. Sterilization brings about for the purpose of sterilization is inactivation of lipase and lipolytic enzymes activity, that is fat splitting enzymes, which are responsible for the increasing free fatty acids. Then loosening of roots for the easy separation, softening of roots facilitating digestion, coagulation and the of the mesocarp protein. Stripping, fruits are separated from the bunches. How? Fruit digestion, during the digestion process there will be the release of oil from the pulp, that is conversion into oily slurry. Mesocarp, pressing, separation of liquid component from the seed solids. Clarification, oil is cleaned of water and cell debris and particles of fiber and shell. Then process of the processing of oil, crude palm oil, then refining palmolive. Further purified palmolive has thick consistency and red color. The production of edible oil is less than 2% of free fatty acids content. In edible oil, the free fatty acids content should not exceed 2%. At present in India, oil produce is of poor quality due to the bad quality of fresh fruit bunches supplied from the farmers. If the quality of fresh fruit bunches is supplied to the processing units, production of edible grade oil can be less than 2% of free fatty acids achieved. This is all about oil palm processing and cultivation. Thank you.